fantastic, and like more for its comic value than anything else.
Oh wow, okay. Yeah, because I know Magic has got quite a decent following, obviously, and it's got quite a lot of DLC that comes out for it, of all different like ages and cultures and stuff, so that's pretty cool. But still, like, not well known to be like, oh, everyone knows, and name drops and stuff, so.
Yeah, I know, I don't know why that is, because, I mean, the depth of the game and how much it has actually been advertised through things like Steam has been massive, but still not very many people have gotten a hold of it.
Does that mean you'd probably quite like Bastion?
Now, you see, I've got Bastion. I've got it installed, but I've not played it.
Exactly the same.
And it's not because I don't want to play it, it's that I want to find a day where I've got about the whole day just to play through the game, because...
Say 12 hours?
Yeah, that would be ideal. or say spread it out over a couple of days. 12 hours would be excessive for me, but I've just heard that it is fantastic in pretty much every element of itself. So I wouldn't want to sort of waste it away by playing it 20 minutes at a time and not keeping up with it.
Yeah.
Come on, cameras.
On the retirement list now, finally, is Stefan Miller. That's why I've just left it on there for after our massive. So he is definitely out. So finally, he's got away with that. Sorry, I will continue back down again. I just wanted to stop it there just for a second. There you go, Bucket continues in 17th. Okay. And what about films? You seemed like you had some favourites and non-favourites there.
Well, I'm interested to watch Trollhunter. It's on every wish list that it can be. I do really want to see it. It looks like something a bit different, and I'm quite into that. My favourite film, I'm sort of concerned, might turn up on that bottom 100 on the IMDb.
Let me grab the list.
Oh, this is going to be terrible now. If I say this is genuinely my favourite film, this is why, and then some proper film critics, if you consider IMDb.
Oh, no one is a film critic. No. Critics are just people that are so busy up their own arse, there's no room for anyone else.
Well, they give factual opinions on something that's objective, and that confuses me quite a lot.
Yeah.
If you like something, it's for reasons that no one else can understand anyway.
Precisely. Agreed.
My favourite film that I saw, I've seen it recently, was The Life Aquatic with Steve Zissou.
The Life Aquatic. Oh, okay. Bill Murray. What?
Yeah.
I've not seen this. Do you know what, actually? It's got a rating of 7.2, apparently.
Oh,
so
good.
That's quite high.
The IMDb people are in the boat. Who think that that's a good film?
What's it about? I don't really know it.
Formatively, it's about deep sea exploration in a completely fictional environment.
Yeah.
But it's really just a film that develops all of the characters and then finishes. There's no real direction in which it's going. Just how it's all done, and actually probably most of the cast are really good as well.
Oh, I don't know. You said most of the cast. Does most of the cast mean that you're omitting Owen Wilson? Because I've yet to find him be good in anything yet.
The thing is, yeah. Owen Wilson dies halfway through, so that's all
good
problem.
So, super dupe.
I remember where I saw that movie.
Oh dear! I know it's slightly off topic, but Angelica Houston, how much plastic surgery can one face take?
Yeah.
Oh! I don't remember her looking like that. No wonder she's... And she could be recast back in the Addams Family, only as a different character. Jesus Christ. Who could she be? Lurch? No, that's the wrong one, isn't it?
If they went really over the top and gave her a bit more plastic surgery, she could be the young girl.
Yeah.
I mean, they'd really have to push the boundaries of many medical sciences to do that, but it's possible.
Well...
I was interested to hear about this Rush film, about Nicky Lauda's rivalry with James Hunt.
Yeah, Nick Rowland was talking about it in the chat room. I've not heard of it, actually.
I haven't heard of it at all.
Apparently it's coming out...
2013.
Oliver Wilde...
Olivia Wilde. Sorry, anyone who watches House, I mean, that's the selling point on any film in the entire world.
I've never watched that.
I still stand by Tron, the new film, very solidly because Olivia Wilde is in it.
I've actually not seen that one.
No, I've not. I've just been told it was a disaster, so I've...
I've not seen the original, actually. No, I've not seen the original, so I'm not really in a position to say whether it was a disaster or not. I enjoyed it. It looks very pretty, but I think the film itself is quite bad.
Okay. When you say the film looks pretty, would you just say that Olivia looks pretty?
That contributes, but no, the film itself is... It all looks really fantastic. The whole... Because it's in a game, basically.
Awesome.
They've got all of these silly environments that have got your blue grids on them. It does look fantastic.
Awesome, okay.
But the film's not very good. I mean, the acting.
I don't think you watch those films for the acting, though, to be fair. But, no, it's...
Another films.
Yeah. Pretty true. Well, they do add comic relief. Well, Chris Hemsworth is apparently being James Hunt. He's been in Thor and the Avengers? Oh, okay.
I think if they cut all of his hair... Well, no, actually, because James Hunt did have silly hair, didn't he?
Yeah.
Back in the 70s.
And a man...
Yeah, that could work.
Yeah, and a man called Daniel Bruhl is... playing Niki Lauda, but I can only see German language films apart from Glorious Bastards that he's been in.
Glorious Bastards is a great movie.
Well, they might be going authentic and actually giving him that sort of Austrian German accent. Then
no, well, I suppose it's better than having like Sylvester Stallone come in.
Yeah.
Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Arnold, Arnie, yeah. No, I can't get my guns in the car.
You'll beat me this time. I will.
I'll be back.
If Barney's in it, you just know there's going to be a scene of him on the stretcher while still on fire saying, "I'll be back."
Yeah.
That would be really painful and ruin everything.
He's a random X-ray that his fires everywhere, and he's sitting on his knees in the rain with the helmet and tried my best to drive here. I will. I'll be back.
No, you couldn't put Arnold Schwarzenegger in it. I think they could have gone for Michael Fassbender, couldn't they? Because he's been brilliant in everything recently.
Who?
Michael Fassbender. He played Magneto in X-Men First Class, which is what I've seen him in most recently. And he pretty much carried the whole film in terms of acting.
Oh, okay. I'm so out of touch from... Because I like my own certain type of films. I really am a little bit out of touch from what was big and new and stuff. But I remember my ex was raving over the X-Men film. Was like, this is going to be the best thing ever! Because they was a film buyer, so they would work quite high up in cinemas and buy films and go to premieres and stuff. And they were like, no, must go for it. And then I looked at it and went... Meh.
It was very good. I'll be honest. I mean, like X-Men films, they had the if you say United States, might be going straight overhead, which would be unfortunate. But for those that do like the X-Men films, the first one was very good.
Okay.
And then they made three bad ones, and then First Class was like, no, hold on a minute, ignore them. We can do it properly.
Okay. Give us another chance.
Sorry, we didn't mean to ruin everything. We'll try again.
Yeah.
If anything, what's best about the X-Men First Class film is that Wolverine is in it for literally 10 seconds, says one line that completely sums up his character, and then doesn't appear again.
Because they do like to take the same couple of people and just centre it around them, because isn't there like more than just Wolverine?
Yes, and people don't get this. Wolverine's the worst X-Man. He's the most annoying, the most up himself.
Which must be quite a problem if he's up himself with those claws.
Yeah, he's going to cause problems.
I'm raptured!
That would be an interesting one to explain to the doctors.
It would be, because all the women go after him, and I'd have thought, actually, no, he would just rip you to shreds, my love.
But what was happening, Mr. Doctor, was I was wiping my bottom after going to the toilet. And then this happened.
And I was annoyed at the fact that I'd had an Indian that followed through, and then...
Yeah, that's another point. Please don't, like, sue me for any money for having bought you completely the wrong Indian dish.
Yeah.
I was just throwing numbers at you to see what happened.
Oh dear, never mind.
Another great movie that actually got some very, very split critics when it came out earlier. In Time.
I've not heard of that. I saw...
Yeah, Kim is upset.
Yeah.
I saw... that was actually, on Olivia Wilde's IMDb.
No. Sure. Yeah, she played the mum.
Yeah, she was in it.
Yeah, she played the... she actually died in it.
Well, that must be rubbish.
Yeah, well, actually, it's quite... if you can say it's placed in the future, when money is not anything you have anymore, you have time. When people pass the age of 25, they don't age anymore. They have 1 year, and they have to earn more time to keep living, and thing costs money. Costs time. So, it's with Justin Timberlake in the lead role.
Really?
Yeah, he does a good job in this movie, but he's not a good actor. That's true. But I actually like the movie. You should see if you have.
I might give it a try then. I might head down to Blockbuster during this week and pick up Troll Hunter and In Time.
Yeah, you should.
Splash out, I dare ya.
Don't tempt me.
So the reason why we're not covering much of the race is that because everyone at the moment has really spread out and nothing has changed. So sorry about that. Someone was moaning and saying the commentary sucks. Well, you try it for 12 hours, mate. So we've talked about the race for a good 10 of it. We're now having a break for a smidgeroo. And whilst nothing is going on, we shall continue to talk about exactly what we want to talk about. And if you don't like it, click the off stream. Bye.
Unfortunately, it's not quite being the 24 hours of Daytona where the leaders stayed within about 3 seconds of each other for the whole race.
Yeah, exactly. What's we've got going on? What was I going to say? I've forgotten. Oh yeah, if anyone likes a film that's a little bit arty-farty, because I do like arty-farty films, have you seen a film called Kai on Iskatsi?
No.
Okay, it's part of a trilogy, and there's no words to it. It's basically film set to a backdrop of music, and they get a little bit... more and more we're ruining the world as they go on further into the trilogy, but the very first one is quite like a blank canvas of it presents you images and you kind of make your own thing about it. It was done in the late 70s, and it was before, you know how they do like montages and stuff now where everything's like sped up and like all the traffic's going nuts everywhere. It was the very first movie to try and really do any of that. And it does it on a really, really massive scale. And the man that directed it, or helped direct it, was called Ron Fricke. And he does another film called Baraka, which is just awesome. And, I recommend anyone that doesn't mind a little bit of arty-farty films to get Kai on Iskatsi and Baraka.
Hello.
Hello. Who's that?
Hello. It's a person.
Yeah, I need to comment this. Because there's a beautiful car on track at the moment.
What, the safety car?
Look, no. Oh, did you see that?
Oh, wow. Yeah.
So, we've been enjoying your movie talks.
Okay.
Sure.
Would you like to contribute?
Not on movies. But
what would you like to
contribute? Something about the race. There is something really strange. When you come up certain people and try to overtake them, they have a tendency to punch the brakes. That is the most stupid thing that you can ever do. Just keep the line, don't touch the brakes. I hit someone in the rear just because of this, and I had to go and repair the car and leave the car to Andre again. I would have done another stint, but I lost 20 kph on the straights, so there's no point continuing.
Yeah, I think you're drawing.
Any particular offenders, or just in general?
No, in this case it was Roy.
Yeah, but I was sitting and I was watching when Roy, he was actually trying to let you pass, but it seems like he misjudged where you were going.
Well,
so, but he didn't mean that to happen.
Fight!
Don't touch the brakes, because I'm like almost 100 k's quicker, and even if I see he's braking, I can't stop the car, so I just hit him in the rear. I hope I didn't crash his car, but our car was crap after that. Going down the Mall South 20k slower is really boring. you can't even catch a P2 car like that. I'm just sitting having company with a very good friend of ours, John van der Geest.
Yay!
Yeah, he's the number one fan of racing when he's not driving with us.
That doesn't really count if he's a fan of the team that he drives for, does it?
Well, of course it does. He's a huge fan, and he's a great guy, and I'm going to send a bouquet of roses to our lovely Dutch guy.
I think you might give him the wrong impression.
Yeah, tulips.
We've been doing that for years.
Don't do lilies.
I won't. So, still a good fight. Anywhere? There's only between the car in third and fourth position, 35 seconds.
And that might actually
I think this is
going to
be pretty static.
Hmm.
Teams are settling down, daylight is coming.
Holidays are coming, holidays are coming. Always Coca-Cola. John van der Geest is saying they pay me money to cheer. I think there are holes coming in your story now.
Well, I'm going to give him maybe €5 for sure. He got PayPal. Well, so far I think consistency is paying off. I don't know if you see the number of pit stops. I think
it doesn't quite work out, but I'll bring
12.
Them up.
No, we have 12 now. Leaders have 8, second place 8, third 8, fourth 7.